of applications. As the light of the camera will mess up my heart. Here we go.
Hey Ingo, do you know what time it is?
Of course, it's time for 5 minutes with Ingo. All right, so today we will talk about something interesting in machine learning, which is called ensemble methods. The idea behind ensembles is that you have a committee of experts. Every expert might be, well, know something about this field, but by combining all their opinions, you get actually a better combined opinion, like a compromise. And those compromises are typically very good in terms of, for example, of predictive power. So there are two basic techniques. I mean, there's multiple techniques for ensemble methods, but two very famous ones. One is called begging, and the other one is boosting. We'll discuss boosting a little bit later. But begging is interesting because we all can relate to the idea behind begging. The idea is to ask different people, and we will do this actually in a couple of minutes, ask different people, what do they think, how many M&Ms are inside of this bowl? So they will come up with a couple of estimates. We ask for like 10 people, and then at the end we take the average of all those estimates, and you will see something very interesting, that the average actually is a pretty good estimation. So I can tell you now already, inside this bowl there are 585 M&Ms. So let's see how well this committee of experts is actually, or how close is this committee of experts actually getting to this true actual number. So let's get out of here. Let's ask some people for their opinion, and let's see how this works out. Let's go out here and ask this young man if he wants to give us some estimate here.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Would you like to get a $5 Starbucks gift card? All you need to do is tell me how many sweets are in there. Just an estimate, of course.
738.
Say 900. A lot.
Yeah, a lot, right?
500?
500 sounds like a perfect estimate.
288.
What do you think? How many are in there?
450.
1,000?
120.
900?
900?
325.
Okay, so here we have our bowl with the 585 M&Ms. And we asked the bunch of people what they did they think, how many M&Ms are in there. Let's think about those numbers again in order. So we start with the smallest number, which was 120, was the lowest estimate, which obviously is pretty far off. Then we got 250, 288, 325, 450, 500, which is pretty close, 738, 900, 900 again, and then finally 1,000. And again, the 120 and the 1,000, the two ends of the spectrum, are probably pretty far off. But now the interesting thing is, what happens if you calculate the average? The average of all of those numbers is 547. Think about this, how close this average to the actual number 585 actually is. It's only 38 M&Ms off. And this is a concept which we know as something we call the wisdom of crowds. The wisdom of crowds is a good book. I can recommend this. And it's about like how the opinions of many people can actually form something better than the opinions of individuals. So definitely worth reading, not necessarily about machine learning, but it follows the same concept. So now, one important thing here is that even the closest estimate, which was 500, was kind of like 85 off. So even the closest was worse than the average, which was only 38 off. And that really is the power of begging. So the other method I mentioned in the car was called boosting. So the important thing for begging is that all those opinions are actually independent of each other. But for boosting, that is not the case. So let's, for example, say we have an expert for, let's say, green M&Ms. So this expert could have a look at those six green M&Ms here. How many others? No, it's actually seven. And this expert looks at them and says, like, look, I'm an expert for green M&Ms. Let's say those are seven. Okay, so that's good. And then we have another expert, let's say an expert for orange M&Ms. And this expert here looks at this heap, and now he can actually use what he just heard before. So this expert can now say, well, if those have been seven, then I'm going with five here. So those expert opinions now can build on top of each other. So they're no longer independent. They actually reuse the expertise of the others. That is really how boosting, or the idea of boosting, works. So it's not independent, they work on top of each other.
So Ingo, how do you implement boosting and begging?
You might need it for machine learning, yeah. Well, it's kind of of straightforward. You have a bunch of weak learners, as we call them. So, for example, for begging, you just take 10 different models, and they don't need to be super good. And then you basically combine all those predictions. So it's just the normal classification or regression prediction. Let's say for classification, then you just take the majority of the selected class. For regression, you can use the simple average of all the predictions. So for boosting, it's a bit different. So here you start with the first weak learner, and then typically what happens, let's say, for example, for other boosts or others, what typically happens is after you made a prediction about some of the data space, you weigh those examples down, those data points down, so they no longer are really considered. So the next expert then focuses on the other data points which have not been considered before. And again, they build then on top of each other. And I guess that's for today on Ensemble Methods. Thank you.